At this hospital in Santo Domingo, a teenage girl awaits a life or death decision. The 16-year-old girl is dying of acute leukemia and needs chemotherapy. But she's 9 weeks pregnant, and doctors fear the treatment would terminate the pregnancy, a violation of Dominican anti-abortion laws.
My daughter's life is first. I know that abortion is a sin and that it goes against the law because I'm a teacher. But my daughter's health is first.
Under Dominican law, life begins at conception and abortion is strictly prohibited. A bioethics council that rules on the application of the law is leaning towards allowing the treatment because the girl's life is in danger.
At the end of the day, the patient may decide for himself or herself. In this case, the family may decide what's more convenient for the patient.
Women's rights groups are outraged. They say the girl should have received chemotherapy the moment doctors decided it was necessary to save her life.
How can it be possible that so much time is being wasted, that the treatment hasn't begun yet because they're still meeting, trying to decide if she has the right to receive treatment to save her life? That's unacceptable.
Some Dominican opposition lawmakers say there should be a new debate over the ban on abortion in the Caribbean country. The Dominican Republic outlawed all abortions in 2010. Article 37 of the Constitution, approved that year, doesn't leave any room for interpretation or exceptions.
The Constitution is going to have to be modified sooner rather than later, because articles like that are an aberration. We cannot allow under any circumstances that pregnancies that present complications for women be permitted to continue as normal.
The Dominican Minister of Health said he favors chemotherapy over protecting the pregnancy, but doctors are reluctant to act for fear of prosecution.
We back the decision by the health ministry, which ordered the procedure. There's a possibility that the child may be affected, but that doesn't justify an abortion.
And while the debate rages on, back at the hospital, the clock keeps ticking. Rafael Romo, CNN, Atlanta.